Hello students, welcome to our online class. Today you will learn about a new topic, division. Okay, terms related to division are dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. Okay, when we divide two numbers, it divides with each other exactly in some cases and in some cases it may not be divide with each other and leave the remainder. Okay. So let's take an example. 98724 divided by 12. Let's check whether these two numbers are divisible with each other or not. Okay. This is our dividend and 12 is our divisor. Okay. So we will have to divide first. 12 is of 2 digits. So we will have to divide 12 with 98. So now we can take 12 as 96. Okay. Now subtract both the number 8 minus 6 2 and 7. Then we can take 12 to 24 3, and 2 will come down 32. So we can take 12 to 24. 12 minus 4, 8, and our last number will be 4, 84. Then we can take 12, 7, 84. Look here, this is our remainder, and our remainder here is 0. So we can now say that both the numbers are completely divisible. Okay. So this is our quotient 8,227. Okay, here I have written dividend. This is our divisor. This is called quotient. And this is called remainder. Okay. Let's take another example. Here I have taken another example. 8,247 divided by 5. Okay. Let's divide 8,247 divided by 5. 5 is of 1 digit, so we have to divide 8 with 5. So we can take here 5 1 is 5. The dividend always be greater than the divisor. 8 minus 5 3, then 2 will come down 32. Then we can take here 5 6 is 30. 2 and 4 will come down 5 4 is 20 here. 5 4 is 20. Then 4 7. Our last number is 7. So we can take here 5 9 is 45. 2. There is no more number to come down. So this is our answer. And look here, our remainder is 2. Means both the numbers are not divisible with each other. Okay. Now we can write here. Quotient equal to 1649 and remainder equal to 2. Okay, this is our dividend, this is our divisor, and quotient and remainder. Okay, there is a formula to find our dividend, whether our division is correct or not, we can easily identify. So write the formula here, dividend equal to quotient into divisor plus remainder. Okay, now we can put the value of every term. Okay, or we can write it as first divisor into quotient plus remainder. It is also correct. Okay, here I have written first divisor. Divisor into quotient, quotient plus remainder. Okay, according to your book. Okay, our divisor is what? 5 into quotient is 1649 plus our remainder is 2 here. If we have to find the product of this number, we need not have to multiply both the number. We can easily subtract 2 from our dividend. Okay, our dividend is what? 8247 minus our remainder is 2. So 8245. Okay, the product of 5 and 1649 will be 8245 plus, according to the formula, our remainder will be add with the product. So finally we can get 8247. This is our dividend. In this way we can check our division, whether it is correct or not, we can easily find out, or we can also identify, or we can also know the dividend. Okay, there are some properties of division. Now we will discuss. There are some properties of division. Okay, note it down properly. If a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. This is our first property. Okay, here I have taken 14 divided by 1. So our quotient will be the number itself, means 14. Okay, here I have taken another example, 7 divided by 1 equal to 7. Look here, our the number and our quotient both are same. Okay, our second property is, if a number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. This is our second property. Look here, 9 divided by 9 equal to 1, our quotient is 1. Okay, 15 divided by 15 equal to 1. Same, when we divide same number with each other, our quotient will be 1. Okay, our third property will be, if 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is 0. Okay, 0 is divided by any number, divided by any number, the quotient is 0. Look here, 0 divided by 3. Our quotient will be 0. Okay, another example, 0 divided by 8 equal to 0. Our quotient will be 0. This is our third property. And another thing you will have to keep in your mind, that any number divided by 0, that will be meaningless. Okay. For example, 6 divided by 0, it will not come any answer or any quotient. So I have written here meaningless. In this way, you can do all the division. Okay. And I hope you understood the topic properly, and you do all the exercise from your, all the numbers from your exercise. Okay. See you in the next class. Bye.